Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel, welcome to my new subscribers, thanks for being here everyone, and thanks for watching. So this is What's Your Ex's Karma. So for group one we have playtime. Fun is calling you, number seven. Okay, then we have for group two, the dark path, number 10, learning from your mistakes. And then group three, we have fire, number 5, to light my path. Okay, so take what resonates, leave what doesn't. If it's not your pile, choose another pile. If it's not your story, I have a playlist with all my karma readings in there. And don't forget, these are energies as well, guys. You can just swap it around. So anyway, I'll see you there. Hey, group one. So if you chose playtime, fun is calling you. So with this energy of your ex here, from what I'm getting here, this person was constantly on the go. Okay, they may have traveled with work. Even though it says playtime, this person didn't know how to have playtime. They didn't know how to balance life, you know, balance family and work. It's like they were obsessed with, I don't know, making a living. Also, from what I'm getting with this card as well, is that maybe for some of you, this person may have stepped out on the relationship as well, you know. But we'll have a look, okay? So let's see. So Spirit, tell me for group one, what did this ex do to hurt group one? So we're going to look at what they did, you know, and then we'll go from the for the karma. Okay, so Spirit, tell me, what did this energy do to group one to hurt them? What did this ex do, Spirit? Okay, so I feel like with you guys, okay, group one, I feel like maybe when you tried to approach this person and speak to them about how you were feeling, they were very stubborn, they didn't want to listen, okay? It's like your feelings didn't really mean much, you know? And I'm hearing you do as you're told, the fool, okay? Tell me more about this fool. Calm down. Eight of Cups. Okay, that's very weird. Do you know that's so funny? Okay, I don't know how the hell did these get in this deck? That's so weird. Okay, I'm just confusing myself here because this is a new deck and they come with spare cards. Now, I'm sure I removed these cards, but obviously I didn't, which is really weird. Let me move these out of the way. It's really funny how this card came out, okay? And when I was looking at the cards, before I go any further, for you guys, it's very weird. And I'm actually going to stick that card there, even though it hasn't got a picture on it. Because I'm looking at the fall. Now, with you guys, okay, you thought you were getting a fresh start with this person. I feel like there were so many times that this person would, you know, say that they would change, they would make more of an effort, you know, and you took a risk on this person. But every time something came up, this energy would walk away from you, okay? You know, like maybe an argument. It's like they didn't put any effort in. And it's like this person had like a brick wall, you know, like this. That's what I'm seeing with this card right here, like this wall, you know, this barrier that you couldn't get through, no matter how much you expressed to them how you were feeling. And for some of you as well, I feel like for some of you, they may have actually left you for somebody else here. Like I said, you know, with the playtime here, they may have approached somebody else, you know, to start something new. And, you know, they may have stonewalled you. They may have actually, what was I going to say? Just like ghosted you. It's like just cut off all contact with you. That's what I'm getting from that blank card right there. It's like this person that doesn't exist to you guys anymore, but not because you didn't want them to exist. It's just like they just disappeared. So tell me, doing that again. Tell me about the Fool and the Eight of Cups, please, Spirit. Fresh. Oh, God. Okay, we'll take them. So I want to clarify, I'm going to leave that up there, okay? I want to clarify the Fool and the Eight of Cups. So we do have the Page of Cups. We do have the Two of Cups. We do have the Magician. So I feel like with you guys, okay, maybe when this person travelled, you know, with work, they may have had number of women or men in, you know, every state, every port, every, I don't know, town, the High Priestess, the Eight of Pentacles, and the Two of Swords. Actually, sorry. Nine of Pentacles and the Two of Swords. And there we go, with the energy with the Seven of Swords. Thanks for clarifying, Spirit. So this energy was doing something that they shouldn't have been doing, okay? They were sneaking around behind your back. They were lying to you. They were closed off. They were trying to avoid confrontation here. You know, maybe you got suspicious and you tried to confront them. But this energy, overall energy of this ex of yours is someone who's really sneaky, okay? And a cheat and a liar. It's like I said about wanting to try with you or maybe start again, you know, make things work. And this person would be, you know, they would promise you something. And like I said, they wouldn't stick to it. So the promises were like half-assed promises. Because the cup with this Page of Cups here, you know, this cup was being offered to somebody else here. It's like this person, I feel like, did fall in love with somebody else here. Okay, they were more so committed to somebody else, not you. So it was like they were half in, half out with you. This person wore a mask, they were very two-faced, very, very clever. Very clever at manipulating you. You know, and this energy tried so hard to keep these secrets from you. You know, every time you got closer to the truth, they would do something here, maybe cause an illusion here, or, you know, I don't know. But they worked really hard to keep these secrets from you. Whoever they got involved with, though, they were telling this other person that they were single, that they weren't in a relationship with anybody else. And this energy is saying that they were very conflicted. No one cares really, but anyway. This energy is saying here to you guys that I was conflicted, I was confused. I knew I had to make a decision and I dragged it on. And they know that they were sneaking around and doing something that they shouldn't have been doing, but, you know, they still did it. So we do have Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. I want to clarify this Seven of Swords. Tell me about this Seven of Swords, please, Spirit. Wow. Okay. It's like they're flying out, but they're flying out in chunks. So we do have the King of Cups. We do have the Ace of Cups. Yep. Page of Swords. Ten of Swords, a Betrayal, Nine of Wands, Four of Wands, and Six of Wands. Now, this is what they were doing behind your back, you know, lying to you and deceiving you here, because this King of Cups giving their love, their heart. This is what winds me up about exes sometimes, honestly. because then you guys are left questioning yourself, well, why wasn't I good enough? You know, why couldn't this person give me the love that I deserved? You know, you tried everything, you did everything, you know, right, but this person just took advantage. And it's nothing on you guys, okay? It was never you guys. It was this energy here that's just so selfish. And, you know, you got to page your cups with your relationship. You got someone who was, like I said, half in, half out, very immature, like not very sure of what they wanted with you. But then you've got this King of Cups that was given to somebody else, because we're looking at this sneaky energy here. Now this King of Cups was giving everything to the other person. You know, they've been caring, sympathetic, you know, compassionate, loving, affectionate. So this energy could actually be married with this person, married to this person. Now that we do have the Four of Wands and we do have the Ace of Cups, that is marriage and commitment. Okay, so this energy is with this person. But what makes me laugh, it's like, even though they're with somebody, they still watch you with the Page of Swords. They still keep an eye on what you're doing. Yeah, and, you know, I mean, the Ten of Swords is the ultimate betrayal, okay? That's someone that hits that rock bottom, you know, that you're at that dark place, okay? I mean, this was like a complete and painful ending for you. Well, this one swanned off and fell in love, and, you know, they got everything that they want. But, you know, as I say, when I respond to some of you guys, is karma doesn't forget your address. You know, not only did you hit rock bottom and you were at the lowest point in your life here, you had to pick yourself up again, okay? This wounded you very deeply with the Nine of Wands and the Ten of Swords. But you know what Spirit is saying, okay? You, Group One, you know, you've got so much courage, okay? You are strong. You were strong people. And you got through it. But this energy feels like that. Oh, God. What the? No. It's like this energy feels like they are so above everybody else and above you here. It's like, I won. I've got everything that I want. And it's like, I feel like they like to look at you to see if you're suffering or not, whether you're still in this energy right here of the Ten of Swords and the Nine of Wands. They it's like they love it. They absolutely love it. So if you're on social media, Group One, posting sad things, okay, because, you know, some people do that, and there's nothing wrong with that, this person's getting pleasure from it. So maybe you may want to think about not posting anything like that. Maybe start posting pictures of you in your best life, or in your bikini, or you know, if you're male, in your shorts with your top off, you know what I mean. You know, start posting stuff that, you know, even if it is fake. But anyway, I'm petty. So let me just see. I want to see what they're looking at here, why they're looking. So we do have Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces again. So strong water sign here, okay? We've got Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, and that's it. So tell me about this Page of Swords. Why are they spying? Why are they spying, Spirit? King of Swords. Okay. Tell me, why the King of Swords? Why are they spying? Queen of Cups. Queen of Pentacles. The Chariot. This energy's got a freaking cheek, honestly. Absolute cheek. So the reason why they're spying, because they're looking at you taking, you know, ownership of your life, okay? This may have happened a long time ago, but they're looking at you become really independent and you're thriving, okay? I mean, you've literally come out as the King of Swords, the Queen of Cups, and the Queen of Pentacles here. And you keep moving forward here. You are... It's like I'm picking up regret here, okay? Because they're seeing how well you're doing. They know that they messed up here, because with the Queen of Pentacles, this is somebody that is valued, okay? This is something that they should have realized, that you were valuable. It may have been you two together when you were younger, and now you've matured into this beautiful, you know, person, okay? And you're thriving. Then you've got the Queen of Cups, who's someone who is very loving and caring, you know. Then you've got the King of Swords, who is someone who's very clever, that's, you know, that's like a no-nonsense type of person, you know. And with the Chariot here as well, it's like you are moving forward and you keep moving forward. And they have to sit there now. They have to sit there and... Oh, here we go. There we go. They have to sit there and watch you with the Six of Cups and reminisce about the things that you... That you had, and also reminisce about what they could have had with you. So there's huge regret here. So obviously they've come through the energy of, yeah, I'm Billy Big Balls and my life is so wonderful and I'm really happy, but really you're not, because you're still spying on Group One and you're regretting it a lot here with the Five of Swords. They feel defeated. They feel like you actually defeated them. Even though they're in this energy here that they came through, it's like they're lying in this reading, if you know what I mean. It's like you are not. You may be victorious when it comes to your relationship or this marriage or whatever it is that you've got going on, but Group One is actually doing so much better than you are. And it's like there is no coming back from this, ever. And they know that. And it's like that, you know, with the Five of Swords here, they know that they wasn't very nice to you, okay? They could have treated you better. So let me just see what this energy would like to say to you. Let's just be a bit nosy, okay, before I get onto the karma. So what does this energy want to say to Group One? What would they like to say, Spirit? Literally all came out reversed. The Hangman, Three of Wands, Death in reverse, Seven of Cups, Strength, Five of Cups, and the Seven of Wands in reverse. Okay, and on the back of the deck we do have the Knight of Pentacles. They want to tell you that they're really that they have no, their life is, what's the word, for goodness sake? They're dissatisfied, okay? There's no satisfaction for them. They're discontented. They're not interested in what they've got. That's why I feel like they're watching you, because they're more interested in your life than they are their own. And they're saying their life is literally just at a standstill. It's like my life is not going anywhere. And it's like they're looking at you moving forward with the Chariot, and you keep going. There's no stopping you, Group One. And this is what they have to admit to themselves, how they messed up here. Hang on. A See, they want a return, okay, with the Three of Wands in reverse, okay? You know, when it's upright, it's yearning, pining for someone, missing someone, or returning from travels. So this person wants to return, but they know that there is no way forward here. There is no way they can return from what they did with death in reverse as well, you know, because they know they made a bad choice. This person is experiencing a really bad situation and a bad change here with death in reverse. And they want to move forward with you, but they're so fearful. I mean, like, come on, really? That's why there is no contact here. They know that it... I mean, at least this energy knows that they would be taking the utmost P out of you guys if they were to have the audacity to do that. You know, they've found clarity here in the time apart from you, that they were weak-minded when it came to what they did. They have a weakness, is what they're saying to you. Wow. And, yeah, this person, whoever this is actually admitting to you that they're getting some kind of help. So it could be therapy. I feel like this person's got a sickness. You know, maybe they've got thingy addictions, sex addictions, you know. Yeah, they're that's what they're saying. They're saying that they've quit the behaviour, they've quit all that what they used to do to you. And they've sought help. Now, don't you start beating yourself up about this, okay? Like I said, we do question ourselves as human beings. We're only human. Of, well, why can you change for somebody else? But this energy hasn't changed for anybody else. They're actually changing for themselves, okay? They realize they have a problem. I don't think you guys really care anyway. So let's have a look at what their karma is. And I've got my karma cards and I bought some new karma cards as well. So, Spirit, tell me, please, what is this Group 1's ex's karma hurting them? The kind of gift. Five of Coins. Mental health. Could be struggling financially at the moment. Things are just not going very well for them. I feel like there may be coldness between the person they left you for. Let me see. Tell me about the Five of Pentacles. Why the Five of Pentacles? What is their karma? The Devil and the Empress. Oh dear. They've experienced a financial loss, they've experienced isolation, mental health is struggling, their health is not doing very well at the moment. I mean, and to see the Devil in reverse is actually, you know, they swapped you out for Empress in reverse, and because when I saw this person thought, like, obviously, you know, this is their other half, you know, twin flame. We've got the soulmate card there, so they thought they were getting the divine feminine or masculine. And what they got was somebody that has bled them dry, okay? Someone that is very greedy, someone that messes with their mind, you know, so there could be manipulation tactics or just, you know, gaslighting or something like that. It also could be they could be getting over some kind of addiction as well, but we're looking at their karma, so forget that bit, you know. And the Empress in reverse, it's someone that is actually cheating on this energy now, your ex. This is somebody that is abusing your ex now, so it's like they met their match here. This is someone that they, this energy, your ex, lacks any confidence. It's like this Empress in reverse, and I never really get the Empress in reverse. It's literally knocked this person's confidence. So your ex could have been someone that was really, like, you know, admired by people, you know, good looking, but this person's at rock bottom here with Five of Coins. So it's like spirit is, you know, saying, well, your karma now is you're going to experience the same. They say like attracts like, you know. Tell me more about this Empress. Yeah, they're married. So for you guys, you know, or they could be in just a really long committed relationship, like common law man and wife. And this energy's stepping out, giving to others here. This energy is constantly unfaithful. Not your ex, the partner that they're with, the Empress. Constantly stepping out of the relationship here, going out partying a lot with friends. They're never at home. I feel like if they've got children, this your ex here looks after the children while this person goes and gives to other people. So it seems to be their relationship that's affected here. Any more, spirit? What is this ex's karma for group one? The star in reverse. So we have Taurus, we have Capricorn, we have Aquarius, we have it came out sideways. Nine of Swords and the Tower. This person's being judged. And part of their karma is constantly having guilt over what they did to you. It's like, I feel like spirit, you know, because these are angels, okay? These are people that have passed over in the card, you know? It's like they're being haunted through their nightmares here with the Nine of Swords. So they're constantly being reminded of what they did to you. So they're having nightmares. And like I said, they're being haunted by spirit for what they did. It's like they can't seem to get away from the guilt that they're feeling. This is part of the karma here. This is someone that's experienced a lot of anxiety and depression, a lot of sleepless nights, a lot of worry. You know, with the star card in reverse, I mean, it can still be positive, but it also could be someone that feels so stuck. Things are not moving on forward for them. They're not able to manifest anything. You know, it could be spirit is saying you're in prison at the moment, if you know what I mean. They're experiencing so many tower moments in their life here, you know, and I feel like sometimes you've got to experience these tower moments to come out a better person. I mean, look at the way, okay, because I see this as the Four of Wands as well, because, you know, you've got the four pillars here, and the Four of Wands is like a house on some of the cards on stilts, okay, or pillars, or whatever you want to call them, and it's like, the part of the karma is, it's like bit by bit, spirit is knocking down this tower, knocking down everything that they've built up because of what they did to you. And most probably others as well. You know, I feel like this person was a serial cheater, not an actual, just a one-off. I feel like it was multiple people. So if this energy was doing this for years to multiple people, what do you think is going to happen? So I'm going to get my karma cards here. So I'm going to tell you now, guys. These cards are quite dark, okay? It's so hard to find karma cards, even though I haven't printed mine. I'm still going to use mine. So they are very dark. So if it upsets you, you know, I apologise. But, you know, it is what it is. So, spirit, what is this energy's... this ex is karma for her in group one. So, God. Okay. Look. Doesn't mean that that's what they're going to be doing. Is, I can't say that. on here, what word can I use? Hang on. Anyway, you read that, okay? So it's I'm trying to find a bloody right word because you've got to be very careful on YouTube. So anyway, I don't feel like that is what they're going to do, okay? This is, please don't start panicking. No one would ever wish this on anybody, but I feel like they have contemplated this because, I mean, Five of Pentacles, it's like they are at rock bottom. We've got the Nine of Swords as well. We've got the Tower. It's like just pure devastation this person's experiencing. Unwanted pregnancy. Now, and that could have been it as well, you know. It could have been that they, you know, because the Empress is someone that is pregnant. It is pregnancy, okay? It is birth, but it could be that it was unwanted. If they've got multiple children, maybe they didn't want to do this, you know? So what is this ex's karma? Nerve damage. I did say they wasn't feeling very well. Weight gain, maybe drinking too much. Blocked love, uh-huh. This person's not well. Guys, I do believe this person's really not well. But I really wouldn't wish that on anybody. And I feel like that's why they've sought some kind of help here, you know, to help with what they're going through. I mean, maybe they did attempt it, you know, and you may not know about that. You know, group one, you were good people, but sometimes people think with their bits in their pants, you know, not with the thing that's up there, which is your head. Okay, social services, children's services, CPS, whatever you, other people call it, are involved, practitioner. So this Empress could be doing dark magic on this person, okay? Yeah, dark magic, that's one of the worst things apparently you can do. I explained this on my last karma reading. It's the energy, apparently the worst karma to receive is dark, you know, if you start putting dark magic on other people, because you're taking away their free will, you know, you're affecting their energy. So maybe this energy here, this ex of yours, may have tried to do it with you, you know, maybe to get you back, and it backfired. Who knows? Maybe you guys felt a bit funny at one stage. Maybe out of the blue you started thinking about your ex here, and you're thinking to yourself, for God's sake, why am I thinking about this person? You know, it's things like that that you have to watch for. So protect your energy, guys. So what is this ex's karma for group one? Sorry, I shouldn't laugh. But I did say that, so, you know, Spirit did clarify this for me. We've got community ho, okay? So I did say that the partner that they're with is, you know, so they're going to did I not say at the beginning, karma does not forget your address? Karma's knocking. And then on the back of the deck, we have no sex. So, now let me get mine. Mine are not so harsh. Okay. So, Spirit, tell me, what is this ex's karma for group one? Okay. Financial disaster, which we've already seen. What is this ex's karma? Oh. Well, that's clarified. Where is it? The one on the back of the deck there. Crap sex life. Okay, so we've got smelly bits that they could have called a STD. They will always be judged by others. Yeah, so maybe family and friends are judging them because of who they got involved with, you know. Being compared to others. I feel like this is the person they're involved with, okay? I feel like this is the Empress that's, like, coming home and rubbing it in their face. This is awful. People hate their energy. This used to be someone so confident, okay? You know, we do. No, it was on. It was earlier. Someone so confident, and you wouldn't recognise them now. That's what I'm seeing. Okay. Maybe ending up deciding to get a divorce, finally hitting rock bottom, never getting over heartbreak. And that is, the heartbreak is you, group one, because like I said up here, you guys are such beautiful, strong energies, okay? Powerful, you are a leader. You literally took leadership of an ownership of your life. Once you got out of that rock bottom energy there and that hurt, you, it's like this energy doesn't recognize you. This ex does not recognize you anymore, okay? And good for you. I would high five you guys, but I can't. So let's have a look. Dreams will come true, but quickly turn into hell. That's like the star in reverse, you see. It's like they're trying to manifest things. You know, it's like spirit's giving them little crumbs. Lack of funds, which we've seen multiple times. There you go. Depression will age very quickly after. Yeah, that. When I put that down, I feel like that's what, if you were to ever bump into them again, you'd be like, holy moly, what the heck? And they're losing friends or they've lost friends. Is that group one? Oh, actually, no, group one. I'm not ending it there. I want to get you a little personal message for yourselves, for a boost for you. So what message do you have for group one, please, spirit? So we have divine assistance. Your prayers have been heard. The divine is currently supporting and guiding you. Allow yourself to receive. So maybe this is the problem here, okay? For some of you, this may be something that's happened recently and the divine is helping to guide you, you know. For some of you, it could be that maybe you're questioning, well, why is this person living so happily? And, you know, where is the justice? Your prayers have been heard is what spirit is saying. So what more do you want to say to group one? Let's take that. Okay, let's take those two. We have spiritual growth. Prioritize your spiritual growth and don't allow the cares of life to squeeze out your goal to grow spiritually. Okay, so keep going on your spiritual journey, guys. You guys obviously are very spiritual. And this is what's more important. Don't let outside, you know, outside problems and life get in the way of your spiritual growth. Believe in miracles. You have to take risks. Miracles will only happen if you allow the unexpected to happen. Okay, so some of you may be doubting, you know, yeah, I feel like some of you may be questioning whether, you know, will karma eventually catch up with this person, but sometimes, you know, it's not even up to us whether karma wants to go knocking. When they knock, they'll knock, okay? So group one, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this reading, please hit like, it helps. Comment down below, love to hear from you. Take care, guys, much love. Hey, group two, so if you chose the dark path, okay, learning from your mistakes, with this energy, okay, straight away I'm picking up this was a karmic. Maybe this karmic and you met because, you know, like karmic soulmate, met each other for you to, you know, maybe end the karmic cycle or, you know, learn your lessons as well. And I know some of you really hate hearing that, but come on, guys. Earth isn't really a bed of roses, is it? We're always learning. So with this ex of yours here, this is somebody that chose a very dark path, okay? They may have had a dark energy as well, like the devil energy. Yeah, this ex of yours really made a lot of mistakes. This Let's see. Tell me about this dark path spirit. What did this ex do to hurt group two? Ten of Cups in reverse. Page of Swords in reverse. They did something here that they didn't. What did you do? Hang on, I'm gonna leave that like that. So there was either a divorce for you guys or a separation, okay? You know, with the upright, you know, this is home and happiness, happily ever after. But this energy, your ex broke your home. With the Page of Swords, this is something that happened, okay? Some kind of news that was received or delivered here. And this energy did not speak out. They did something really, really bad. And they've never owned up to it, okay? Or, let me see. Tell me about this Page of Swords, please, spirits. We do have Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Tell me about this Page of Swords in reverse. Okay, so what I'm seeing here straight away is this, whoever didn't speak out, this energy did not speak out and tell you that they were feeling unfulfilled, okay? They were bored. Tell me about this Page of Swords in reverse. World. Nine of Swords. Nine of Pentacles. So for you guys, I feel like this energy didn't even bother telling you that they weren't happy in the marriage, if you were married, or the relationship. And this energy could have just basically ghosted you, up and packed and left. About this world, you know, this energy, your ex was feeling anxious, okay, stressed. Ace of Wands, yeah, look, they went off and they went and started a new beginning here. I feel like they may have even gone traveling, they may have even left the country for good. It could have even been a new romance here, something to do with immigration as well. Tell me about this Ace of Wands. What did they do, Spirit? To group two. Tell me about the Ace of Wands. Bear with me, because it's like this energy is it's like they're confusing me. This Ace of Wands, please. So we do have the Eight of Swords in reverse. We have the King. King of Swords in reverse. Three of Pentacles. Page of Cups. King of Wands. They wanted to escape the relationship. Okay, escape the home, escape the marriage, they were being selfish. They would prefer to keep all their finances to themselves and go off and be single, be free, no responsibilities. This is what I'm seeing here. Okay, so they wanted to escape because they felt like they were in a prison with you. With this King of Swords though in reverse, ugh. This is like somebody that was like power hungry, you know, they felt like they had to have control all the time. And I feel like this is what's happened here. This energy, this ex here, has never admitted to what they did to you, because my King of Swords, in reverse especially, is a narcissist, okay? Abusive, aggressive, not a nice person. Aggressive, brutal, violent, controlling, no integrity, a cheat. You know, this energy could have been talking to other people here as well, you know, building something with someone else. But I feel like they lied here, you know. Maybe they were saying they want to be single. I need to see this. I need to check this Nine of Pentacles here, because that is someone that is single, someone who wants to be on their own. But were they lying? This energy here would have like outbursts, big childish outbursts as well. And I feel like that's when they lashed out on you. You know, I feel like you were dealing with a womanizer here, or if you're the other way around, I don't know what word it is. Actually, I do know what word it is for the feminine energy, but I'm not going to use it on here, you know. You swap it around. Hang on, I want to know about this Nine of Pentacles first. Tell me about the Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, they had other options. They had either somebody else waiting in the wings, or they had multiple options here. Okay, this is abuse as well in a relationship. Tell me about the Seven of Cups. Nine of Cups, greedy, somebody who was greedy, they were looking out for themselves. So tell me about this King of Swords in reverse. We do have Gemini, Libra, Aquarius again, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Tell me about this King of Swords in reverse, Spirit. What did this X do to group two? Literally just clarified what I said. This person really, okay, trigger warning, guys. You know, and look how you guys have come out. You were, you know, no matter what this energy did to you, okay, you were still there offering this love to them, still being compassionate, still trying to understand this person. You know, you were still very warm, you know, and kind and sincere. And all this energy did was abuse you. You know, this is these two cards. This King of Swords made you hit rock bottom, guys. That you, I don't think you even recognized yourself. I feel like you guys may have lost weight. You may not have been eating properly. You may not have even been sleeping. So, like I said, trigger warning. There was physical abuse in this relationship. And it wasn't, I feel like it went on, like, I'm seeing more than 10 years here, okay, for some of you. It went on for a long time. This person was a liar. They were sneaky. They would cheat. It's like they were wearing so many faces here. I'm going to clarify them two cards. I just want to grab something, because sometimes, you know, you don't know what, you don't grab certain cards when you're doing a reading, but with your reading I will, with these cards here. But I'll put them there for now. Okay, let's get back in. Hopefully I've got my camera. So, Spirit, tell me, please. Tell me about this Ten of Swords and this Seven of Swords. What did they do? So, you know, they were stepping out on you. I feel like they had... So, you know, this person don't want me to talk. Let me just grab a drink, guys. Hang on. It always happens when you get certain energies that are like this. So, I feel like this energy stepped out on you quite a lot. So not only were they abusing you physically, mentally, emotionally, they were also cheating. Look at this. Oh my God. You really got involved with someone that is really dark here. You know, this is mind control, controlling, addictions, violence, codependency. So tell me about the Ten of Swords, the Seven of Swords and the Devil, please. We do have Capricorn energy here as well. Ace of Cups. Tell me about the Ten of Swords, Seven of Swords and the Devil, please, Spirit. Eight of Cups, Queen of Pentacles, Knight of Cups. You know, I feel like this energy left you when you were at rock bottom. They left you to pick up the pieces. I feel like they took everything from you, you know, financially as well. Because all they were interested in was starting again with somebody else here. You know, because the Knight of Cups is somebody that is wooing somebody else, you know, expressing their love for, you know, usually it's for you if it's a love reader, but I'm clarifying this toxic energy right here. So they were giving... They were charming others or another. And I do believe it was the Queen of Pentacles here, okay? And Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Because they felt like that this Queen of Pentacles would be more valuable to them, you know? Maybe financially. So I feel like they left you at a time that you were so... low, you know, I'm on about, I feel like you guys were so, like, on the verge of giving up. Where's those cards? Right, tell me more about this King of Swords in reverse. What did they do? Sneaky behaviour. They're engaging in some risky behaviour. Be sure to protect yourself and be safe. But we already saw that with the Seven of Swords, you know. What did this ex do to group two? Control. In an effort to control your behaviour, they lied to you. Let's just clarify on that devil. Awful energy. Lies, lies, lies. Unavailable in another relationship or emotionally unavailable. I think it was the whole thing. I think you forgave this energy here so many times. Bad motives, scheming, they are making secret and underhanded plans. And that's what I feel like that. This is what I do feel like this energy did here. It's like the way they left was so sneaky. Like, maybe that's why I got a bit confused at the beginning. I don't know. Cheating. Look, devil energy right there. A sex addict. They have a hard time controlling their sexual urges. Manipulation. They say one thing but do another. Giving a mixed message. How many times does it want to come out with cheating? The narcissist, they cheat to feed their own ego and feel entitled. No, not that many, spirit. Come on. Let me do that again. Okay. So we have sneaky behavior, witchcraft. Someone is casting spells to control a situation. So be careful. Maybe this energy is into witchcraft, but then that's the worst karma, as I said in group one, that you can receive, because you're affecting somebody's energy here. Bad motives, using you. They only need you when they need something. So maybe this energy still keeps coming back for some of you, okay? Mental abuse, there you go. They gaslight you and also mix signals. So I want to see what this energy wants to say to you, okay? I did it in group one. I want to say, wow, stop. Tell me, what does this energy want to say to group two? Wow, okay. Six of Wands, Three of Wands, Nine of Wands, Four of Pentacles in reverse, the Fool, Page of Pentacles, the Strength, the Hangman, you know what? Whatever, I shouldn't have even asked. Really should not have even asked. To be honest, this energy is awful. Yeah, this energy is really awful. Their attitude, it's like their energy is so, so crappy. It's like, what they're actually saying to you is, I'm off having a good time here, you know. I know you're still missing me, basically. But I'm still someone who is in charge. I'm still the one that came out on top. You're the one that's still carrying around the burdens, you know. This energy is saying that basically you were just a burden to them. That's why they let you go, because they wanted this new beginning somewhere else. And this energy does really feel like they are so powerful here with the Strength card. It's like, look at me. All I'm getting from this energy, okay, is that they're boasting about how they are and how they're doing here. You know, like, work's really great here. I'm working really hard. Finances are really great here. I shouldn't have asked, to be honest. I knew I shouldn't have asked. Just, maybe, you know, but narcissists don't really show remorse, do they? Ever, because they never think that they're wrong. Tell me, spirit, what's this energy's karma for her in group two? What's this ex's karma for her in group two, please, spirit? King of Cups. Tell me why the King of Cups. What's their karma? Judgment. Temperance. Energy here is either overspending, or they're doing something, you know, because they are the devil here, like excessively, you know. It could be drugs, it could be alcohol, it could be any number of things like that, okay? The spiritual world here is like, hell no, you're not getting away from this. We are actually judging you. Things may have not happened yet to you, is what spirit is saying, but we are up here judging you. And it's like Judgment Day, isn't it? It's about, you know, it's about to come. This King of Cups is about to have a big wake-up call here. I want to know about this judgment. Tell me, Spirit, what is this karma for this ex? Tell me about judgment. Oh God, calm down. Five of Pentacles. Eight of Pentacles again. The Lovers in reverse. Ace of Wands. The Emperor in reverse. And the Ace of Cups. Now, did we not get that with these cards here? We had the Ace of Cups and we also had the Ace of Wands. Something's about to happen between... Look, we have a couple here, okay? So, we have the King of Cups and we have the Queen of Cups. Something is about to happen between a couple right now. This ex's relationship that they're in, okay? I mean, it may be that they actually fell in love with someone, you know, like genuine love here. I can hear crying again. Some of you could have children with this energy here, okay? This ex. Because, you know, the Ten of Cups is family, you know. You've built a life together. You've had children. So the karma here, this judgment here, is what Spirit is saying that this person's going to be experiencing hitting rock bottom, okay? You know, like what you was in at one stage. Their finances are going to struggle. Their mental health is going to struggle. Their health in general is going to struggle. Okay, they're going to start maybe feeling unwell. And and you know they're going to try really hard to try and work on fixing this, but it's like, I feel like with this judgment here, no matter what they do, it's just not going to fix anything here because they are being judged, okay? They're getting their karma. And then the Lovers in reverse is unrequited love. You know, it's separation, it's conflict within a connection here. So there's some kind of conflict here. There's an imbalance, which we do have Temperance here, in this connection between these two, okay? There's trust issues. There's disharmony. There's something seriously wrong here. They're experiencing a lot of disappointments and a lot of setbacks in this connection. The Emperor as well is someone who is very weak. This is what's happened, okay? This energy was the Six of Wands, okay? Someone very powerful, someone, you know, has achieved something, someone that people looked up to. And now they're the Emperor in reverse, which is someone that is very, very weak-minded, okay? Someone that is in a connection here that is experiencing excessive control. So I feel like they've met their match here. So where they could do anything to you, okay? Anything to you. Now it's the other way around that they can't actually get away with this. I feel like they've met their match. So it's now that they're under this thumb, you know, they're being controlled themselves. They're experiencing, once again with the Ace of Cups, unrequited love, sadness, pain. All by the hands of a Queen of Cups. I mean, look how she's looking there. She's not exactly like, she looks a bit evil in this deck. I just heard, I hold all the cups, you know, cups, the cards, whatever you want to call it. Tell me about this Queen of Cups, please. What is this karma? Alright, come down, Four of Swords. This karma is, the Queen of Cups is emotionally draining this person. It's like the Queen of Cups is constantly she's a drain. It's like they're tired of constantly, maybe they're being nagged, maybe they're being, you know, oh, like I said, really, like, controlled. Tell me more, what this Queen of Cups doing? So maybe this Queen of Cups is actually this king, you know, your ex's karma, then, you know. Sometimes we're other people's karmas. We've got the Six of Swords here in reverse. There's trouble coming in this connection. What is this trouble that's coming? What is this karma? Six of Wands. Okay. What is... Wow. Wow. Trouble is coming. The Devil again. Okay. Something's about to turn very, very dark between these two here. Trouble could be maybe the Orex is going to do something that could end up, you know, violent or something like that. Tell me about this Devil. Something bad is about to happen. Tell me about this Devil, please, Spirit. I feel like they shouldn't really put it out there. There's going to be a trip or something, like a road trip, a journey that your ex is going to go on, and I feel like they may be involved in some kind of accident here, and I feel like maybe your ex is maybe dealing with a third party here with the Queen of Wands. This can be seen as the other woman or the other man. So they've been putting effort and energy into this Queen of Wands here, and it's like they're traveling somewhere here, and this is what the bad news is. It's something's going to happen here. Tell me about the Chariot. What is going to happen, Spirit? Oh, God, calm down. The Princess of Wands. That's a Page of Wands in reverse, and King of Pentacles in reverse, and the Magician. This is an ungrounded masculine here. This energy is not learned from anything. They've not learned from the past. They're never going to, okay? There's no hope for this energy. No hope whatsoever. There will constantly be the Magician here playing games, being deceptive, wearing a mask. And I feel like they're journeying to this Queen of Wands here, and something is going to happen. This is somebody who is unfaithful when the King of Pentacles is in reverse here. Yeah, they're being unfaithful. But I feel like there may be some kind of vehicle accident here. So let me have a look. Right, so I've got these new karma cards here. I'm going to use mine as well. And they are very dark, okay? So I'm just giving you a warning. What is this ex's karma for group two, please, Spirit? Gun charge. Now, I did say something is going to happen here. I don't know, you know, maybe they'll be caught with possession in their vehicle, you know, unlicensed gun. I don't know how it works in America. We do not have guns. So I don't know how it works. I think that's how it works. I don't know. Yeah, so they're going to be in trouble with the police here. Saggy skin. Oh, wow. Yeah, something is happening here. We've got the police now. I even said something may turn violent between the Queen of Cups and this ex of yours, okay? Something is not good in paradise. Loss of business or supporters, and I did say financial ruin. We could have the big C. I did say these cards are dark, okay? No spiritual protection, uh-huh, and we do have judgment. What else? Excess karma for group two. Drug addict, yep. That, you know, the devil did come out twice. I feel like maybe they're just going to get high and something's going to happen. Physical pain. Let me do that again. Ooh, hang on, tickles. All right. Court case. I feel like this ex of yours, yeah, they're going to do something very, very bad, okay? Very naughty. And they're going to end up in court. I'm surprised the prison card didn't come out. Let's have a look. Physically assaulted. So maybe the Queen of Cups may end up assaulting them, or maybe, wow, paralyzed, crippled. Look, this is literally going along those lines, okay? Somebody in the relationship that they're in is cheating. I do believe it is this King of Swords, okay? Something bad is going to happen between the Queen of Cups and this ex of yours. There could be a car accident. There could be, you know, violence involved. Because they're going to know that, you know, they were betrayed. Or they're going to feel betrayed. So, you know, we do have paralyzed. So if there is a car accident, you know, I don't know. And I did say this is the worst kind of karma that you can actually receive here. It's funny, isn't it? People think that if they do a good deed here and there, they're, you know, they're not going to attract that karma. It's not true. So what is this ex's karma? Shattered dreams. Toxic relationships. Thank you, spirit. They will see your face and name wherever they go. So they're being haunted by you. You know, spirits haunting them anyway. I feel like they do have nightmares about you guys. You know, we do have the Nine of Swords in this reading as well. Financial disaster, which has come out three times now. Blocked intuition. Partner will not want to have sex with them. Nightmares, what did I just say? Alright. STDs, sorry. I'm that car coming, I feel like I'm such a child, but it's satisfying. They will be constantly reminded of you. There you go, that's come out twice now. Mental illness, which I already said. Rejection. I mean, maybe they find out that their partner's cheating, they go on a rampage, you know? Only you guys would know. No genuine friends. They will never get over the person that they loved. But see, I will. I don't, you know, don't take this the wrong way, group two, okay? But sometimes it's good to hear it. There wasn't any love here for you. You were just like this conquest, this thing that they had to overpower. You know, it made them feel powerful. It made them feel like a, you know, the all-powerful one. That is what the King of Swords is anyway. And because you love this person so much, you know, you came out as a Queen of Cups, you really wanted so much more from this energy, this ex, and they just was never giving it to you. They fell in love with this person that they're with, but they're now experiencing rejection just like you did. They're never going to get over the one that they love as well. They're going to be haunted by that. Okay, you wanted to come out, you flipped in the air. Triggered in their next relationship, spirit. Someone close was still their man or woman. Yeah, I feel like there's something that's gonna... Oh, okay, mate. Wait a minute. Because this is really bothering me. Where are you? I'm messing up my cards, but I don't care. Tell me, spirit. Who is this Queen of Wands? Six of Cups. Ten of Swords. Ten of Pentacles. This is somebody, okay. I feel like this may be the Queen of Cups' past love here. Someone that they still pine over and miss, okay? And this is, you know, like, we've got the Three of Wands again here. This is someone that goes to travel to see somebody here. This is the ultimate betrayal. This is seen as the other person. So it could be that, you know, the Queen of Cups is the one that's doing the physical cheating. And this is where this, you know, narcissist, devil energy, big ego explodes and goes on a rampage, okay? Something bad's going to happen here. I feel it quite strongly. So I'm going to, oh no, I'm getting you guys a nice little message for you lot. Not this energy anymore. So what message do you have for my lovely twos? All right, Spirit, God. I'm going to take them because Spirit obviously wants you guys to hear it. Hidden treasure. The treasure you are looking for is hidden in the ground you're standing on. It is time to dig deeper. So something you've been... that's a bit strange. Maybe you guys have been looking for something. Maybe this energy hid something from you, you know, if you still own the home. Spirit is saying dig in the ground, okay? It could even be, you know, digging within yourself, okay? Dig deeper within you. The hidden treasure is there. Obsession. No amount of obsessing is going to make a situation better. Find a way to let go. Okay, you guys are still obsessing about this situation. Like I said, you did really love this person, but stop holding on. Because Spirit is saying it's turning into a bit of an obsession, okay? Divine assistance. Your prayers have been heard. The divine is currently supporting and guiding you. Allow yourself to receive. So Spirit is supporting you, okay? Your spirit guides are supporting you. Your angels are, they're guiding you. Listen, believe in miracles. You have to take risks. Miracles will only happen if you allow the unexpected to happen, okay? So believe. Maybe you don't believe anymore because of what's happened to you, but Spirit wants you to believe. Spiritual growth. Prioritize your spiritual growth and don't allow the cares of life to squeeze out your goal to true spirituality, okay? So keep growing, you know, keep practicing spirituality, okay, guys? Stay in touch with Spirit because it's really important. So anyway, Gritchy, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this reading, please hit like. And you have a lovely day. Much love, guys. Hey, Group 3, so if you chose fire to light my path with this ex of yours, okay, this could be someone who is very religious or hid behind religion, okay? They could have come from a different background, you know, different culture to you. So it's like they hid the fact that they weren't really a good person behind religion. This energy as well would have big outbursts of temper and aggression, okay? So let's have a look. As a spirit tell me for Group 3, what did this ex do to hurt Group 3? Justice. We could have a Libra. This energy did something that obviously was pretty bad. Two of Pentacles. So Justice is like, you know, doing something, you know, doing something wrong and being, you know. Oh. This energy judged you for something. I feel like they were very judgy. Like I said, it's something religious here with this energy. I feel like they took religion to the whole next level. Tell me about this Justice and this Two of Pentacles. You were married to this person, you know. We do have the Four of Wands, or you were just in a serious committed relationship here. You built a home with this energy here. You could have children with them. This could have been your twin flame, but it could have been a false twin flame. It's like this energy sat on their throne, okay, while you were the one that was juggling home, family, commitments, work. What's this justice here, Spirit? What did this X do to group three? Queen of Pentacles, Ace of Pentacles, King of Swords, what a surprise. The Moon, the Knight of Wands. I feel like they took from you financially, okay? I feel like you were the breadwinner, group three. You were the one that earned more money, or it could be that you came from, you know, generational wealth, okay? So this energy would just sit back while you did everything in the home, like I said, work, because they knew you were valuable, okay? They knew they could have the lifestyle that you could give them. So this was a taker. This was never a giver. You had the better paying job. I don't even feel like this energy really worked. Why am I hearing a YouTube, a social media platform here? Why did I just hear that, Spirit? I feel like this energy would spill on social media about religion and spirituality and things like that, you know, while you went and did all the hard grafting, while this person took from you, while they sat at home and they did, you know. This ex of yours was hiding a really deep, deep dark side to themselves. And like I said, I feel like they were hiding that from the world as well, okay? You had an energy here, an ex here that was in and out, that wasn't, you know, they may not have been faithful to you. You could have also had a narcissist as well with the King of Swords, someone that is actually someone in authority here. There's something about this ex of yours that had power over people, over you. And there was a control element here in the connection. There was a lot of lies in this connection as well. Talk about this King of Swords and the Moon. This was just on the back of the deck, the Ten of Pentacles, and now it's in reverse. They caused a financial disaster, okay? They lost this generational wealth. They lost something really, really big here. What did they lose, Spirit? Why the Ten of Pentacles in reverse? I think one day this energy just, or they took it from you, you know? Oh, calm down. So we do have the Nine of Wands. Tell me more about this Ten of Pentacles and this Nine of Wands. High Priestess. It's like that saying, not all that glitters is gold, you know, or glitter, whatever the bloody saying is. It's like, that's what I'm seeing here. It's like they sold the dream, and the dream was a disaster here. This energy, that's what I'm saying, covered in so many secrets here. This is what's just very confusing here. It's like they don't want to give me the information. And there's secrets here. And but what? Just bear with me, guys. Let me try these. Tell me about this Ten of Pentacles. This Ten of Pentacles in reverse. What did this ex do to group three? Well, for one, they taught you a valuable lesson here, and maybe to never trust someone that even you're committed to, or never give over that power to someone when it comes to finances here. But they ended something here. It's like, I feel like when the money ran out, it's like they left. You know, what have I got here to, you know, why am I hanging around? Tell me about this world and this Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, they were reckless with finances here, reckless with something that was, you know. Tell me more about this ex spirit, please. Give me more information, please, for group three. There's that Four of Swords. There's that Nine of Wands again. Tell me about this Nine of Wands. Wow, there's that Four of Wands again. Like this energy did invest in something and it literally backfired. You lost group three, you lost everything. And then when the going got tough, this energy just left. Tell me about this Four of Wands. Yeah, look, wow, thank you, Spirit, for clarifying, because that was getting on my nerves. Poverty. Like I said, they literally up and left. I feel like they, you know, they may have even stolen from you. They may have even took it themselves. But I am seeing more so that they invested in something and it backfired and they just left. They up and just left the country from what I'm seeing. They left you in poverty here. You may have even lost your home, group three. Everything that you worked for was gone. Tell me about this Five of Pentacles here, please, Spirit. Yeah, look. The Tower, Two of Wands, there's that Two of Pentacles again, Six of Cups, Nine of Swords. Yeah, they chose a different path from you. They decided, I'm going to leave you to it and I'm going to go and deal with myself here. I don't care whether I destroyed everything that you worked for, your family worked for. They didn't care. They caused such a huge Tower moment in their life. Knowing that they left you to struggle with the children, with the home, with the family, you know, with your feelings of everything that you shared. They know they just left you to, you know, put it all back together. They left you in the Nine of Swords, anxiety, depression, sleepless nights, worry, tears. You know, they've caused a big ending, a big change in your life, like I said, because this energy was greedy. They moved on while you were stuck here, having to deal with this mess that they left behind. So tell me a bit more, please, about this ex for group three. Strength. Eight of Swords. Yeah, look, snakey. They may have stolen from you guys, okay? They surrendered to this greed. They did, they surrendered to it. So the I wanted the freedom to, you know, spend the money, you know, the finances as they wanted to, and they felt restricted by you. Maybe there was some clause in there somewhere and they found a loophole and they managed to get around that. So there they are with their Seven of Swords sneaking off with those swords there. So that's stealing, lying, cheating, deceiving, you name it, why they've gone off and swanned off to have a good old time on their boat here, you know. Why you have been left in the Eight of Swords, who is in a mental prison, who is depressed, who's, you know, at the stage of, it's like you felt like you couldn't go on. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. Tell me about the Seven of Swords, please, Spirit. My stomach is growling, as always. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. They did this so quickly as well. I don't feel like you saw it coming, guys. The Hermit. So we do have Scorpio. Sorry, guys. We do have Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Libra. Leo. Virgo. We have the Nine of Pentacles. We have the Hierophant, which is Taurus. And there's that Ten of Pentacles again. Wow. That came out three times. Twice upright, once in reverse. So they did this very, very quickly, like I said, okay? They were sharing some kind of information here, okay? Maybe there was a group of people that stole from you. There was some kind of sharing of information. I'm going to clarify that. Yeah, look at this. This energy, okay? They felt isolated. They felt restricted, like I said. Like, there may have been a clause on spending, okay? And they wanted it all. This is greed. Pure greed, okay? So, they may have had someone else help them. I don't know here. But with the Nine of Pentacles, they felt like they had no independence. It's like they relied on you. And this is where resentment started to set in, because they're having to rely on you. But they sure didn't moan when they had to spend, you know, when they wanted to spend the money. This was somebody that would overspend. And here we go again with the Hierophant. Like I said, it was something to do with religion here. Maybe they were given to the church. Maybe that's how they managed to do it, because they wanted this generational, you know, look at this, Frank Spirit, they wanted this generational wealth for themselves. They were so greedy. This was pure, pure greed. And they took advantage of you. You know, I feel like this is what they took from you, was this Ten of Pentacles here. You lost, I feel like you did lose everything. Like, everything. Turn about this Devil and Ten of Pentacles, please. We do have Capricorn. Turn about the Ten of Pentacles and the Devil, please, for it. Two of Cups. Seven of Cups in reverse. And there's that keeps coming out. The Three of Wands. I feel like they left the country. I really do. I feel like they disappeared. Why this Two of Cups and Seven of Cups? I mean, this energy could have left with somebody else here, okay? May have chosen someone else over you, because there we go again with the Knight of Wands. This is somebody that is very promiscuous, that has no staying power, okay? That puts it about. that Ace of Swords. I'll come down. We do have the Emperor, and we do have the Seven of Pentacles, and the Wheel of Fortune. Yeah, this is a karmic. Yeah, it's a karmic. There's someone very, very greedy, okay? And because they were the Emperor, the Divine Masculine here, they had that authority, okay? They had that, like I said, sitting on their throne, and it's like, you do as you're told, and they left you to deal with everything while they sat there in their Emperor form here. But this is somebody that didn't really work hard for anything here, is what Spirit is saying. This energy brought about such misfortune to you, okay? They, like I said, rock bottom. This was your downfall here with this Emperor. They didn't want to put in any work. They couldn't be bothered. They didn't need to work on anything. They watched you grow your empire, if you want to call it that. And, you know, and they reaped the rewards. And I feel like they also did steal from you. So this is just pure greed right here. So Spirit, tell me, please, actually. What is this energy's karma for her in group three? What is their karma? Thank you. Knight of Swords. Eight of Wands. The Hierophant again. Four of Cups. Part of their karma is they're stuck in this Hierophant, you know, this holy religious thing that they've got going on. They're stuck. They have to keep up the pretense, okay? It's actually boring them. It's boring them. They're just not finding any satisfaction in keeping this up. So it's... It's like this energy wants to take action. They want to get away from being this Hierophant here, but it's like they can't. It's like they can't. They want a change of lifestyle here, and it's just, it's not. It's not possible. That's part of their karma, that like they literally are stuck. Bear with me. Tell me, what's this karma for the Hierophant? It's like this energy hides behind religion. Wow. Ace of Pentacles in reverse. So once, you know, when it was satisfying and it was paying off, you know, people were given to this energy here, and you were given to this energy as well. The Ace of Pentacles is... They thought they were getting a new beginning when they moved on, okay, and may have stolen from you, like I said. So instead of getting that new beginning, it's like they haven't got that. They lack money here. Here we go again. It's here again. Four of Pentacles. Because you're greedy... And... You feel stuck. I'm talking to this energy. You lack funds now. Where is the funds gone? Tell me about the Ace of Pentacles in reverse. Three of Pentacles. They've had to give to others here. They've had to keep up this facade of, you know, maybe they work for a church or something like that. Like I said, it's something very dodgy, is all I'm going to say. And they've had to give to... other people, you know, I don't know what it is that they do here, but this is why they're lacking funds, because they've had to work with other people, or they've had to share this wealth with other people. Tell me about the Three of Pentacles and the Ace of Pentacles here. And this is part of their karma. We have the Two of Wands, the Ten of Cups, Six of Swords, An Ace of Swords again. You know, maybe they tried to keep this hidden when they, you know, we've got the same cards again here. So they may have actually tried to keep this hidden from family members or from the family in the church, if that's what they do. But it's like now that the truth has come out about maybe them being financially abundant here, which is due to yours. This energy, this ex here is having to give it to people in need, okay? They're having to give back to people that need it, like families. I'm wondering whether this is a crossover. There was a karma reading I'd done a few weeks back, and it was a similar sort of story, okay? Maybe you were married to the person, but it was a couple that was conning people online, and I've had quite a few comments on that pile, because I thought, well, it's very weird, I've never had a reading like that before. And they were putting out spirituality and, you know, religion and things like that, but these two people were such a con, but they ripped off so many people, like, I'm on about, ripped them right off. And some of the stories that I heard for that pile, I'm like, geez. Like, you know, you do know it does go on out there. We all do know that. And this is what I'm seeing here. It's something in a community here, and they've had to, it's like now they're struggling finances. They lack funds. And it could be maybe they lack funds. Maybe you managed to get some of your wealth back, and they lack the funds to support this thing that they've got going on. Scam. This is what I should have said. Scam. Oof. It's like the rich get richer, the poorer get poorer. But this energy here, you know, and then like you have, I don't know what I'm thinking of, Robin Hood, where the Robin Hood would come in and give to the poor, you know. And this is what I'm seeing. It's like karma. Spirit is like, we're coming in and we're going to act like Robin Hood now. We're going to start making you give to the poor. Tell me about this Ten of Cups, please, Spirit. So the path that they thought, that this journey that they were on, that they thought they were going to, you know, be all, you know, I don't know, rich, wealthy, whatever you want to call it, is backfired. There's that Chariot again. There's Hermit, Virgo, and Cancer here. Yeah, their plans failed. They have to share, okay? It's called social sharing, and it's literally clarified the Ten of Cups. They have to share this wealth. They have to give back to charity here. You know, and usually karma hits back what you took or what you did to other people, you know. So let me see. So I'm going to warn you now, guys, these cards are pretty dark. So, you know, what is this, X? Is karma, sick kids. So, I mean, maybe they have children and their children are not being very healthy. I wouldn't really wish that on them. But it could be the karma here is, like I said, they're having to give to the sick, to the poor, to the needy. And if they started off like this, they've had to keep up this pretense, okay? I'm not seeing this as part of their karma as in sick children. I am seeing it is that they... I really wish you could really talk how you want on YouTube, you know? But you really can't. So yeah, they have to support unwell children, you know, that's part of their karma. Police caught up with this energy or will catch up with them. So if some of you are going through a court case here as well, because the justice could be because if they stole, you may have actually taken this person to court for theft. Death spells being done on you. So maybe this energy is actually doing something dark, you know, dark magic. That's come out 3 times. And as I said, in the other 2 piles, the worst karma you can receive is when you affect someone's energy, okay? Bad luck, number 13. And that is death in the tarot. Gun charge. You know, things are starting to end for this energy here, spying. So they could be being investigated, okay? If this is a big scam that this energy's been doing for a long time, they could have people spying on them, trying to get information. Community ho, so they could be dealing with thingies on the side. Or they could be the community ho, take it as you want. Saggy skin. Oh, let me do that again. Oh, blimey, calm down. Hair loss. So maybe the worry's making them lose their hair. Depression. Oh, for goodness sake, Spirit. Okay, I'm going to take them because Spirit's like literally keeps doing that. Oh my God, this is like half the deck, Spirit. Money blocked, which I said that. STDs, you know, some kind of STD here. They're aging very quickly. Car accident. Drug addict. They could be, yeah, could be addicted to something. We did have the devil. Cancer. Big C. Physically assaulted. Children's services. Unexpected. Yeah, unexpected, as you can obviously see. Leaked sex tape, body odour, and heart problems. Now I'm going to get mine, okay? That's like I just said, this, you know, when you affect someone's energy, that's like usually the worst karma that you can receive, okay? And look how many cars kept flying out there. It's like this energy, and we've got the number 13 as well. I mean, some people see it as lucky. But you know, ow. Sorry, guys. Can't pay the bills, feeling rejected. Maybe people will be closing doors on this energy, you know, because once it gets out that they're a liar and a thief, you know, they will go grey. We've already seen aging quite a few times with those other cards there. Bad skin. They will lose their home. They will never find love, real love in this lifetime. Let's see if it's going to be their finances. No doors will open for this person. Wow. Lack of ideas. Stopped by the police again. People talk shite about them. People will stab them in the back. Their reputation will be in ruins. Self-care neglect, which we did see here. Blocked finances. Will not be able to connect to anyone emotionally, being left out, no invites. They will lose everything they've worked hard for. Karma's real, eh? Their valuables will be stolen. You know, like I say, karma don't forget your address. So, I'm going to get a message for you guys, okay? So, what message would you want to give to Group 3 Spirit? You need to behave, Spirit. Seriously, chucking them all out like that. All right, wait. A bright future ahead. There are no limits to what you can have. Believe in your dreams and success will follow. So Spirit is saying, you know, that is the sun. That's healing. You were healed from this and you have a beautiful, bright future ahead, okay? Again, guys, because it's just like, I don't know what it is with your pile. It's just like Spirit's got so much to say, but you know, okay, right, whatever, I'll take it. I understand. Divine feminine, so you guys are the divine feminine, okay? Even, you know, anyone could be the divine feminine. We have masculine and feminine. Your feminine energy is out of balance and can leave you vulnerable. Learn to use your feminine power wisely, okay? So this may have knocked you out of balance. So do some meditation to center yourself again, okay? You know, maybe balance all your chakras as well. Do a bit of meditation there. Then we have uproot bad habits. You have let bad habits take hold of your life. It's time to uproot them and start fresh if you want to see a positive change in your life. Okay, so some of you lot are, you know, we all have bad habits though. And focus on your own game. Stay in the lane, do this, and in due time, you will set up an extraordinary life. You know, and that does make sense here. Focus on you, become, you know, get yourself back into alignment, okay? Get rid of these bad habits that you've started doing since this energy entered your life and then left, okay? Because you have a bright future here. So I'm going to leave it there, group three. If you like this reading, please hit like. It really helps the channel. And you have a lovely day, guys. Much love.